Well, we're training really well. We're very lucky in that we went up to Albany for our away trip, our one away trip for the whole season, and we got on a flat, fast course with some really nice weather, and we handled ourselves pretty well. We were kind of running through the meet in that we were training through it because this is the MAC Championships, and this is the meet that really matters, and I think that we pretty much have all our ducks in a row, and we're ready to go. I think it is. I really do. I mean, I don't like to say that everybody has to run the same course in the same weather and all that, but we're there every day, and our teams really kind of looked at this is our home course, and you're coming to our house. So I think it does have an advantage. Well, you know, we've been blessed. We haven't had but 2 days of rain for the entire cross-country season, and now they're expecting some stormy weather right around the anniversary of Sandy. But I think our teams are ready. Cross-country is supposed to be in tough conditions, and I think that I don't think it'll bother us a bit. I think that we'll go out there and do the job despite whatever Mother Nature throws at us. You kind of have to treat it as two races in one, in that you kind of expect with the talent that Iona has that they are going to win the title on both sides, and therefore you have to make sure that you don't get caught up in that and that you run your race, that your team looks for each other out there, and you kind of treat it like two races in one. Let Iona go, and now we're going to race the rest of the conference, and I think that our teams are pretty much focused on that they're not going to get sucked into, you know, a fast early pace, that they're going to look for each other. They've concentrated on doing that in the last couple of weeks, looking for each other in the race, racing with each other, helping each other out, you know, really coming together as a team, and I think that'll pay off in the MAC Conference Championship. I expect Michael Rogeras to continue being our number one, and really he really has stepped up, and besides just running in the one position, he really has been tugging the rest of the team along, encouraging them, telling them, you know, find your place behind me and get in there and do your job. You fulfill your spot and do your job. On the women's side, it's kind of flip-flopping between Milena and Alexandra. Both girls been really vying for the top spot, and basically they're being pushed by the other girls. Freshman Katie Soroka really pushing them towards the front, and I think you're going to be kind of surprised by the girls' results. The girls are a real tight team. My expectations are to finish a little higher than we did last year. Coming in as a new coach and having the championships in a different location last year down in Disney as opposed to across the street, we're a year older. I think that we're a year better. I just think that the expectations are that we expect to finish a little bit higher than we did last year. I would think that the men and women teams will both be in the top five.